everyone, welcome to Level Up, a show where we show you how quick and easy it is to build cool solutions using Google Cloud Platform. My name's Jay, and joining me today we have Anil.
Hi, Jay.
Hi, Anil.
Thank you so much for the introduction. Hey, everyone. Myself, Anil Sagar. I'm a Customer Engineer in Google Cloud. Today, we are super excited to be here with you and share some of the cool stuff that we are working in Google Cloud.
Great. So what are we going to show them today?
Many developers know cloud as a compute, storage, network, and data. Also, developers might be familiar with infrastructure as a code. But today, we're going to see infrastructure as a voice.
Okay, so hold on a second. Are you saying I could use my voice to, for instance, spin up a virtual machine?
Absolutely. Like Jay mentioned, you can spin up a virtual machine by talking to Google Home. Not only that, you can do a lot of other stuff as well using just your voice.
So what's another example of something we might do?
You can ask about Google Cloud data centers.
Right, so because we have the APIs available, right, so you can actually get a list of the regions. So instead of, for example, me going onto Google Search, searching for data centers, going to the web page, looking at that list, I could just ask.
Today, we're going to use one of the API to build this application to connect Google Home with Google Cloud.
Great, so I see we've got Google Home here. You've got your laptop. Well, let's take a look at what we've built.
Absolutely. Let's get started with the application. Okay, so we're going to start with the API.
Okay, and what API do we have here?
So we have the regions listing API, which is going to list the data centers that are spread across the globe.
Okay, so I see on the right-hand side of the screen, you've got the parameters for the request at the top, and then you have an example of a response below.
Exactly. So you can also test this API in Google Cloud documentation. You can hit this execute button, and you can see the response here. For example, as you can see in the response, we have one data center, Asia East 1.
Okay, great. So we have the list of the regions. How do we get that list, though, into Google Home?
That's a great question, Jay. So that's where we are going to use Google Cloud DialogueFlow.
Great. So with DialogueFlow, we'll create an agent. What are we going to call the agent?
So we're going to call our agent as GCloud Jarvis.
Okay, GCloud Jarvis. So for those of you who've watched The Avengers or Iron Man, you'll know that Jarvis is the assistant for Iron Man. And I guess here what we're trying to do is turn these administrators into superheroes so they can control Google Cloud just using their voice.
Absolutely, Jay.
Okay, well, let's take a look at DialogueFlow.
So this is our agent, GCloud Jarvis. And we are going to specify our actions through intents.
Okay, so an intent. In other words, we're trying to figure out what the user is trying to accomplish. So how do we set up an intent?
You just click on the button, create intent. It is going to open the screen something like this. You give the intent name and just train the intent with some of the examples.
All right, so I see you've already put in some examples here, some training phrases. What do the highlights mean on those words?
Highlights are different variables that we want to capture. For example, you might want to ask a question about a particular data center. For example, as you can see here, Singapore is a variable that we want to pass it to the backend API.
Right, and I see we have a couple different colors here. So Singapore, it looks like those are cities, and then we have the ones in blue, which are larger regions.
Absolutely, Jay.
Okay, so great. So we now have these intents. How do we connect this to our API? Do we need some sort of application layer in between that?
Absolutely. So we are going to use Google Cloud AppEngine to develop this application that is going to talk to the backend API. Because the reason is the DialogueFlow is going to talk a language that the backend API don't understand. So we need an application that is going to mediate between the DialogueFlow and our backend API.
All right, so AppEngine platform as a service, so it can automatically scale up and scale down all the way to zero when it's not being used. And it takes away a lot of the headaches of dealing with the infrastructure that might lie underneath.
Exactly. Google AppEngine is an OOPS platform. You don't need to worry about patching, scaling, or upgrades, and Google takes care of it for you.
All right, so we've got our API that we need to call. We've set up DialogueFlow. And now we need to create an application that will be the layer in between DialogueFlow and our API.
Absolutely, Jay. So we are going to create that application using Node.js. So I just got it ready just before this demo. We're going to see the different parts of it.
Okay, let's take a look.
So it's a very simple Node.js application. You can just say npm init and then start the Node.js application, and then maybe use Express Framework to build an API. So let's look at the application. As you can see here, it's a very simple Node.js application with an Express module. As you can see, our API is DialogueFlow-Webhook. And we are going to capture the intent that we created, Ask Me Regions, using this particular block of code.
Okay, great. So we've captured the intent. We're now going to call our function that will then call our API.
Absolutely, Jay. As you can see here, we are calling the function getRegions, which is in this particular file here. As you can see, we are calling the Google Cloud API library, compute.getRegions, that we have seen earlier. And this is going to fetch the data that has the list of regions. As you can see here, we are looping through that particular data and constructing our response.
Great. So we're taking that response from that API, putting it into these text responses that we see here on the screen to provide natural language back to those users.
Absolutely, Jay. So you can deploy this application with just one single command. So we can say gcloud app deploy.
Great. And then, so this is on the command line, so we'll continue. And then, where does this end up? Like, can we actually see it in the console, this app, after it's been deployed?
Absolutely. As you can see here, it says which particular project it is deploying to. Let's say yes, and then deploy the application. It'll take a few seconds to deploy, and also absolutely zero downtime, even if you upgrade your application. You don't need to worry about any downtime, because Google Cloud takes care of it. So once it deploys, you can see your application in Google Cloud Console.
Okay, great. Let's take a look.
As you can see here, our application is deployed in Google Cloud AppEngine. You can see the project name, Anil's-Playground. That is what we have configured. Mm-hmm. And this is the API that we're going to connect to our agent.
Right. So this is the endpoint for the agent. So the agent has an intent. Once it recognizes that intent, it's tied to an action. That action then calls this endpoint.
Absolutely. So we are connecting all the dots now.
Great. Sounds good.
Yeah. So let's do that configuration in the agent. If we go back to our agent, as you can see here, in the fulfillment section, we are giving the URL as Anil's-Playground, which is my project name, and DF-Webhook is the API we have created in Node.js application.
Okay, fantastic. And I see you have some basic authentication here. And then what happens? What happens next?
Let's see how our application works.
Great.
Hey, Google. Talk to gcloud Jarvis.
Getting the test version of gcloud Jarvis. Good day. What can I do for you today?
How many data centers are there?
In Google Cloud, 20 data centers are spread across the globe. 6 data centers in Asia, 1 data centers in Australia, 6 data centers in Europe, 1 data centers in North America, 1 data centers in South America, 5 data centers in United States, for example. To find out more about these locations, say, tell me about data centers in Asia.
So that's very cool. So what we've just done is we've used our voice to call the API that we talked about and get a list of the data centers and then provided a context for that using natural language.
Absolutely.
Now, I remember from DialogueFlow that there were some highlighted words which are parameters. Now, the question I just gave it didn't really give it any parameters, so let's try that again with that specific parameter. Okay, Google, how many data centers in Asia?
In Asia, 6 data centers is in Singapore, Hong Kong, Mumbai in India, Taiwan, Tokyo in Japan, Osaka in Japan.
Tell me about the data center in Singapore.
In Asia, Southeast 1-3 zones are available. Zone names are Zone A, Zone B, Zone C.
So I noticed earlier as well you had some additional actions available. So what else can we do with gcloud Jarvis?
You have a very sharp eye, Jay. You can actually create a VM using gcloud Jarvis. You can shut down a VM. You can also delete a VM. At the end of the day, these are all just API calls.
Great. Well, why don't we create a VM?
Sure. Let's do that. Hey, Google. Create a virtual machine in Singapore data center zone A with 1 CPU, 2 GB memory, 10 GB disk with Debian OS.
Please specify intended virtual machine name.
WordPress.
virtual machine has been created successfully.
Great, that's great. So what we've just seen is Google Home talking to DialogueFlow, talking to the Create VM API, and creating the virtual machine. Now, I noticed with this one, we had to provide several parameters in order for it to create that virtual machine. And in fact, one parameter was missing, which was the name of the virtual machine, and it was able to come back and ask for that additional parameter.
Exactly. So you can say everything in one sentence, or you can just say, create a virtual machine, and the DialogueFlow agent will ask you the missing parameters.
Great. So let's take a look at the virtual machine that we've created.
Yeah. As you can see here, the WordPress virtual machine got created in Singapore data center with one CPU and 2 GB memory.
Great. And I notice it's using a custom machine type, because you can use any combination of virtual CPUs and RAM.
Yeah, it's a differentiating factor in Google Cloud. You don't need to choose the pre-configured machine types. You can pick and choose the number of CPUs and memory that you require for your VM.
Great. Would you like to do the honors of deleting the virtual machine?
Maybe you can do that.
Okay, I'm happy to do it. Okay, Google, delete the virtual machine.
Please specify exact virtual machine name.
WordPress.
Please specify virtual machine region which you intended to delete.
Singapore.
Please specify zone in which VM is hosted. For example, Zone A.
Zone A.
Virtual machine WordPress has been deleted successfully.
Let's see that. As you can see in the screen, our virtual machine is getting deleted with just the voice.
Thank you so much, Anil. It was great to see how easy and simple it is to create infrastructure as voice.
Thank you, Jay.
If you'd like to find out more information, please use the links in the description below. Please subscribe, and thank you so much for joining us on Level Up.